I want to shift our attention to what it all means for the market, of course, as we continue to watch the sell-off and some big themes that we've seen play out, including one big acronym we want to introduce our viewers to here, since we know we all love those. And for more on that, John Traynor is joining us here, People's United Advisors Executive VP and CIO. And John, I say the acronym because it always, I think, helps people remember what some of those themes are. And you got one, T.I.G.E.R., for this year that investors should really start drilling into their heads. Talk to me about why it encapsulates, I guess, what some of the big themes are we should all be watching.
Yeah, the reason for that was, you know, whenever you come off a great year, and we had a great year in the stock market last year, we wanted to basically temper client expectations. So we said, you know, if you look at the Chinese calendar, this year is the year of the T.I.G.E.R. If you're a golf fan, you know, it was great to see T.I.G.E.R. come back. So we thought, okay, you know, 2022 will be the year of the T.I.G.E.R. The acronym stands for the headlines that we think will roil the market in 2022. So number one would be, you know, we had Taiwan, but we put that under the rubric of Taiwan. It could be Ukraine. I mean, we're seeing things in Kazakhstan, but we said there will be political events that take place that could really cause some problems. Inflation, we're seeing that. We're going to get a print this week that could be 7%. We're seeing wage inflation up. G, growth, the economic growth. We think the economy will be slowing this year. You know, that could impact the expectations that people have. This is an election year, the E. So, you know, no decisions in Washington are going to be made without an eye on the November election. And then finally, interest rates. So what we're seeing right now, the I in inflation and the R in rates are dominating the market. We're seeing that really, really, you know, cause some angst in the market right now. The difference between the big growth stocks and the value stocks is phenomenal. I was just taking a look at a couple of indices that we track, and there's already 1,000 basis point difference in some of the performance we're seeing on some of the mutual funds, which is amazing, you know, just a few days into the beginning of the year.
I realize, you know, we didn't book you as a foreign policy expert, but I have to go back to the top point that you highlighted, obviously not just about Taiwan, but Russia too. I mean, you think military action is realistic there? I mean, it seems like all signs point to the fact that there's a bit of saber rattling that's happening. I mean, how complacent do you think the markets are to the risk of some kind of misstep?
Well, the word you use there is perfect: complacency. You know, again, I'm no foreign policy expert, but, you know, in the strategists that we talk with, there was really, you know, when we're taking a look at what they're looking for, nobody was looking at the potential for some upset, either in Taiwan and Ukraine. You know, look at what we're seeing in Kazakhstan, that at a certain point, you know, we could see that. So we just wanted to make clients alert to the fact that, you know, there was a lot of complacency, as you just said, there was a lot of complacency in the market. And we don't think that that's healthy. So we wanted to raise that issue out there. You know, I read Foreign Affairs magazine, and I can tell you that the opinions by people much more expert than I am run the gamut. But we definitely want to be aware of what's going on there.
I guess that would also kind of be a good point to maybe reiterate some of the dangers in calling a bottom, as some people have in some of these Chinese levered stocks. And as we've seen those really sell off last year to wrap up 2021, it accelerated there. People were searching for a bottom there. But when you look back to how that plays into the dynamic between these two economies as they're kind of at this breakpoint, I guess, if you want to call it that, I mean, still increasingly dependent on one another. So, I mean, what does it mean for growth if that is a story to watch this year?
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head. And we actually talked about China. What Xi Jinping is doing in China, basically trying to deflate the property bubble. You know, it's a, you know, an oversimplification, but that's what he's trying to do. It's the right thing to do. But just think about the U.S. We've got the most advanced financial markets in the world. We tried to deflate the dot-com bubble in 2000. That didn't work out very well. We tried to deflate the real estate bubble in 2007. That didn't work out very well. So deflating bubbles is very, very difficult for us. And we can imagine the Chinese. So the Chinese have been such a great growth engine for the global economy that if there are problems, if there are potential problems in China, you need to factor that into, you know, your earnings estimate, You know, think about all the countries that are companies that are doing well with business in China and your global growth estimate, especially for Europe. Europe is a bigger trading partner with China than the United States. So a slowing China could have very, very big ripple effect. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah, and certainly some jitters as to what Xi Jinping does next this year as he looks to officially secure that third term. John Traynor, yeah. People's United Advisors Executive VP and CIO, good to talk to you today.